Hi, everybody, and welcome to Ivy League Analytical English. I'm Karen.
And I'm Wesley.
Today is August 28th, and how did we get to this point in 2018? Wasn't it just New Year's a little while ago?
Yeah, 时间过得好快. Yeah.
Towards the end of August now, and today we have another composition exercise for you. This time it's a composition based on pictures. And we have this wonderful artist here who draws these really cute cartoons to tell you what's going on. So have a look at the pictures and then figure out what's going on in this story.
好,那今天我们是看图作文,所以各位可以看看这个图,那显然我们要根据这些图要写文章了。Okay,
what do we have to do?
我们今天这篇文章的标题是 a false alarm,就是虚惊一场,那我们的提示就是 请大家根据以下三张连环图画的内容,以这句话来开头,那是什么话呢?
Brent and his friends will never forget the time they had a barbecue by a mountain river.
所以这个Brent跟他的朋友永远不会忘记他们在这个山里面的一条河烤肉的这一次的经验。那用这句话来开头,写一篇大概150个单词的文章,描述一下 途中主角所经历的事件,而且提供合理的结局,还有他的解释。Do
you get the feeling that something or someone's probably going to fall into the water?
Yeah,那以这样的一个句子开头呢,其实我们大概就推测,大概有人可能会掉到水里面去的,因为再不然就是山洪爆发之类的,因为这样他才会讲到这个河流,它才会出现这样的一个字。
And it's usually more dangerous than say, for example, a lake, because a lake just kind of sits still mostly. It does have waves, but a river will often have a rapid current and it will carry things or people away if you're not careful.
好,那如果是山里面的河的话呢,这个山里面的溪流的话,常常会有所谓的,可能会很,某些地方很湍急,因为山它有高低的差别,而且呢,有的时候如果这个上游下雨的话, 也会有所谓的山洪爆发这样的这个事情,所以它的危险性当然是相当高的。所以我们大概看这个标题,看这个第一句话,我们大概就可以猜,应该是可能这个有人要掉到水里面或怎么样,但是因为又是虚惊一场,所以还好后来大概没有发生什么事情。That's
right, and I compared it to a lake. Now, rivers are much more common in Taiwan than lakes. Taiwan does not have so many lakes, but it has lots of rivers because Taiwan has lots of mountains. So you can see that this is kind of based on the situation in Taiwan. Mm-hmm. Coming from Minnesota, the first thing I think of is probably a lake, although we also have the Mississippi River coming through where I live and other rivers as well. But we've got lots of lakes, and those sit much more still. They have small waves, but they're not like a river that will carry you away, usually.
好,那这个Karen老师的家乡,美国的明尼苏达州呢,它有很多的湖,也有河,但是 也有很多的湖,湖感觉起来就比较近一点,不像河一样。Okay,
and what do we have to do?
好,那这个写作小站的部分呢,这我们每次都会谈到,看图作文呢,它重点在你要描述图片的内容,所以你可以多注意一下这个图中人物,他们的脸部表情啊,情绪啊,穿着啊,还有人物互动之间的问题,看一看。然后呢,你也可以看一看他们时间,地点,有什么特别的地方。 还有事件到底是大概怎么样的一个事件,你自己先想一想,把这些东西都串联起来,描述一下。通常你可以用第一人称或第三人称来写。第一人称就是你自己本身就是故事里的一个角色,你从你的角度来描写这个故事。第三人称的话呢,你是一个旁观者,所以你可以通常用第三人称就表示你对,你可以给这个图里面的角色取名字,然后说他们之间发生了什么事。那不管是用哪一个人称, 你都要记得用想象力,用逻辑思考,构思出一个合理的剧情,那这个重点要分明,有开头,发展,结尾,前后故事要连贯。那当然,你要注意用转折语来串联一下每张图之间的关系或发展,但是转折语用的时候要小心,不要太这个,用得太生硬。有的时候呢,其实这两个 这两件事情之间没有however的观念,那没有however的关系,那你就不要一定要给他加个however,那或者他们之间没有consequently的关系,你也不要再加说therefore,consequently,所以要注意一下,这个转折语要用得恰当。Right,
before the broadcast, Wesley and I were talking about an experience Wesley has had reading student compositions.
Yeah,因为我最近这个某一个考试的写作,我担任这个评审的工作,那就发现 这个学生呢常常因为我们要这个题目之一是要学生写一个 summary， 好，读一篇文章写个 summary， 那你就会发现学生在写这 summary 的时候常常又用一些很生硬的转折语下去，因为他大概觉得说啊，这两个 idea 之间好像需要某种转折，他自己觉得两个 idea 放在这里接得不顺，那其实是因为他没有读懂，他读懂、
right.
他如果读懂就知道这两个 idea 其实很顺的，但他因为没有读懂，他又觉得这两个 idea 之间好像接得不好，他就会很多学生就会硬放一个转折语进去， therefore as a result there 你就觉得不通啊，
consequently yeah. moreover
nevertheless yeah 那什么 on the other hand 那其实你根本前面那个 one hand 都没有，你哪来的 on the other hand 好，所以这个就是不但是阅读写作都要小心，就是其实你要懂，你要是我们刚刚讲的是阅读写一篇文章的 summary， 但是如果你自己写作的话呢，其实我自己觉得学生有的问题是他自己都不知道他要写什么。
Right.
尤其是你如果今天是论说文的话，他自己都没有想通他的论点怎么走。所以他写出来的时候他就觉得诶这一点跟这一点之间好像连不下去啊，他就加一个 therefore, 啊
或者 moreover.
对啊，或者是 as you can see, 啊我最怕看到那种 as you can see.
Oh, I do too.
因为学生写 as you can see 的时候我通常都 see 不出来，我都看不出来。
And they get a C. 、啊、
对对对。啊，所以这个写作的时候阅读的时候啊，首先我一直强调英文的阅读不像各位讲的那么想的那么简单，你要真的读懂没有那么简单，你要读懂这些 idea 之间的关系。
And I offered a suggestion for when this happens, and please keep this in mind because this really works. When you find that you're not sure how to connect one paragraph with another, or if you have other difficulties on an assignment like this, translate it into Chinese. If you understand it thoroughly in Chinese, because you are a native speaker, your brain will automatically tell you what works and what doesn't and how the ideas are connected. If they still don't connect, then you misunderstood.
好，所以这个 Karen 老师提供这个方法不错哈，很好。你可以这个，例如说你读英文的时候，或者你要在翻译的时候，你如果觉得不懂的话，你可以看看它的，你把它翻成中文，然后看看这个中文之间通不通啊。那如果你觉得不通，那通常表示你的理解可能有问题了。
Use your native language to your advantage, because a lot of people say, "Oh no, no, I'm just going to not think in Chinese at all. I'm going to think directly in English."You don't have a strong enough foundation in English to do that confidently and accurately in the case of many of our learners. So use your native language because you're an expert in it. You can't do really badly. Your brain won't let you. If you hear something weird in your native language, your brain will tell you right away.
好，这个对于大多数的人来讲，你没有花那么多的时间在英文里面啊，不管是学还是求进步，这个时候呢，你有些事情你可能用中文去想，你可能想的会更通一点。因为你有的人说，当然英文，我觉得我自己觉得学英文最高境界就是 to think in English， 但是那个不容易。
That is exactly what you said， 最高的境界。
那个最高境界。
For most of the people in the middle and working their way up to here， they're not ready for that。
Yeah， 那你如果还没有到那个境界的时候，有的时候你用英文想不通的话，你用中文想想会有帮助。
And immediately you will come up with a solution because your brain has been trained to do it automatically.
Yeah.、
Mm-hmm. All right, let's go on to the 构思方向。
好，构思方向呢，检视图片之后呢，我们可以想到构思大概以下这样的一个情节啊。Brand 跟朋友在山区的河边烤肉，那他跟朋友说他要去河里面的泡泡脚。那 Brand 其中一个朋友啊，这稍后去河边洗手的时候，发现 Brand 不见了啊，只看到他的一只夹脚拖啊，这个卡在河中的石头之间。那他担心 Brand 已经被河水冲走了，所以开始大喊他的名字。那这个时候呢，引起另外一个友人注意，那这个他就跟另外一个友人解释啊，现在状况怎么样，你看他的拖鞋在那边，他人不见啊，怎么办啊？啊，故事的结局是 Brand 拿了一根长竹棍啊，毫发无伤的出现。原来他只是去找他能够帮他夹回夹脚拖的东西啊，那他朋友就大笑起来，所以是虚惊一场，他没有掉到河里。
I think it's kind of a cute story myself.
Yeah, 这个蛮可爱的一个故事。
All right, let's look at the English outline. So first of all, it's the 故事的设定, our background. So our topic and title is A False Alarm. Time and place are the time Brent and his friends had a barbecue by a mountain river. And our characters are Brent and his two friends.
好，所以主题是虚惊一场啊。那实地啊，是这个 Brent 跟他的朋友呢，他们去烤肉啊，是在一个山区的一个河流边烤肉啊。人物呢，就是 Brent 跟他的两个朋友。
And next we have our overall outline. Our introductory sentence is, Brent and his friends will never forget the time they had a barbecue by a mountain river.
啊，这我们刚刚看到这一个句子，他永远无法忘记有一次他跟朋友去山区河流里面烤肉那一次的经验。
Next is our development for picture one. Brent and his friends were having a barbecue next to a mountain river, and that's repeating mostly what we just said.
Yeah, 这个前面已经差不多类似的，就是他们 they were having a barbecue, 他们正在烤肉啊。Next to 就是在什么旁边呢？在一条山区的河流旁边。
For picture two, Brent's friends found one of his flip-flops stuck between two rocks in the river, and he was missing.
啊，那他的朋友呢，发现啊 ，Brent 的一只夹脚拖哈 ，flip-flops 啊，这个注意重音在前面哈，不要念 flip-flop 啊，那听起来好怪，那不知道什么东西啊。所以他的夹脚拖呢 ，stuck 就是卡住的意思啊，卡在哪里呢？
夹在
夹着啊，夹在或者卡在这个between two rocks in the river。在河里面的两个石头中间夹在那里啊，然后 he was missing， 那人不见了。
And this might remind you of a pretty popular English idiom: "I'm stuck between a rock and a hard place."
啊，这个就是进退两难啊。Mm-hmm. You're stuck between a rock 啊，你夹在哪里？一个石头，还有另外一个是很硬的地方啊，所以两个都很难啊，两个都很硬，都很难解决，所以进退两难。
Picture three, Brent showed up carrying a long bamboo stick. I might say pole. If it's so long, we'll call it a pole.
嗯，好，那这个他 showed up, 他出现了，带着一个很长的这个竹枝，哈，那个 stick, bamboo stick, 感觉起来是个
竹竿
啊，但如果是真的长的竹竿，会用 pole, 这个是 P-O-L-E, yeah.
Okay, and our conclusion, his friends burst out laughing, leaving Brent scratching his head.
啊，那这个他的朋友呢，看到他之后呢，就笑出来了啊 ，burst out laughing， 就是这个突然之间笑出来了啊。那 leaving 就是使某人处在什么样的状态之下啊，所以他们在笑，就使得 Brent 处在什么状态之下呢？他在那里抓他的头啊 ，scratching his head， 因为他不知道发生什么
事情了。怎么
回事？你们在笑什么呢？我就是去拿个竹竿而已啊。
那有什么了不起 ？OK。And here is our model composition. Brent and his friends will never forget the time they had a barbecue by a mountain river. Brent said he was going to go to the river to dip his feet in the cool water. Later, one of his friends decided to go down to the river to wash her hands. She was surprised that Brent was nowhere in sight. Then she saw something that chilled her blood. One of Brent's flip-flops was stuck between two rocks in the river.Fearing that her friend had been swept away by the strong current, she yelled out Brent's name several times. Her loud voice prompted Brent's other friend to join her at the riverbank to find out what was going on. While she was explaining the situation to her friend, Brent came up to them carrying a long bamboo stick. "What's up? I was just getting the stick to retrieve my flip-flop," Brent explained. His friends burst out laughing.Leaving Brent scratching his head. Pretty good story. Back to the beginning. Brent and his friends will never forget the time they had a barbecue by a mountain river. Now, notice that we have two nouns here, mountain and river, but I stressed both of them. What is the reason?
Because mountain 是地点.
That's right. Because mountain is a place. And when we have a time, a place, or an organization like world leader,We often stress both of them, just like an ordinary phrase with an adjective plus a noun. So we say, by a mountain river.
嗯，好，所以呢，这个 mountain 它是一个地点，好，所以在这里呢，它后面接的那个名词，它也会有重音，好，所以是 mountain river， 哈，不是 mountain river， 哈，是 mountain river。好，那这个地方我们刚刚其实看过这句，不过这里再提醒各位，啊，有一个很好的一个 chunk 可以用，哈。某人 will never forget the time、when 后面加个子句他们做什么事情就表示他永远不会忘记他们做这件事情的那一次
Lately I've been thinking about that Our memories are so selective I can remember some very very clear and specific memories back to when I was 3 years old、Ooh. But there's a lot of stuff in between that I have totally forgotten and、mm. I didn't realize I had forgotten itWith a family member, we were discussing an experience we once had many years ago with another friend in another city. And I was mentioning ABC, and he didn't remember that. And he was mentioning XYZ, and I didn't remember that at all.
Yeah, yeah.
When we put our memories together, it became more complete. But then I realized how much stuff had simply disappeared from my memory and his.
Yeah, 人的选择是很有 人的记忆哈是很有选择性的，
嗯，
啊，所以很多事情，我讲以后各位，如果您现在还年轻，可能还不会感觉到，以后你慢慢这个年纪渐长啊，然后生活经验越来越多，有的时候你碰到老朋友啊，或者像跟家人之间聊起小时候或者很久以前的事情的时候，你就像刚刚 Karen 老师讲，会很有趣，你会发现你记得一些细节，可是呢，其他的完全忘记了，但另外一个人可能是你的家人，可能是你的老朋友，他记得另外一些细节。好，那常常就你们所记得的细节加在一起就比较完整了，但是个别都记得一些别人可能忘掉的事情。
Right, and I find that the things I remember so clearly, even from when I was a really young child, they have to do with language. So I was kind of meant or cut out for this work, because even when I was really young, I was wondering, for example, R-I-D-E-R and W-R-I-T-E-R, writer, are they the same or not? I remember I was about 8 years old and I was thinking, they're close, but they're not the same. And I didn't know the reason. I know the reason now.
Mm-hmm.
But that's something I remember because it has to do with language. So that means that my interest goes way, way back.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this thing that my family member remembered had to do with food. Now, I care about food, but I think he cares more about food. So he remembered a meal that I totally forgot about.
Yeah, 所以呢，这个。每一个人记得的东西跟他关心的东西很有关系、
right.
啊、所以 Karen 老师他很小就显示出来他对语言的这个强烈的兴趣、啊、所以他记得他小时候记得都是跟语言有关系，那这个别另外一个家人可能这个对食物比较在乎、啊、所以他记得都是哎呀我们曾经吃过什么，那 Karen 老师也吃过，但他完全忘了那些东西，
对、yeah. 某某人帮我们做菜啊，请我们到他家来 forgot
yeah
Okay.
Yeah, 所以这个真的是选择性的、啊、
Okay, next sentence. Brent said he was going to go to the river to dip his feet in the cool water. And that sounds really nice.
Dip 就是放到液体里面去沾一下，去泡一下，去浸一下的意思、啊、那所以 Brent 说呢，他要去这个 河边、啊、去把他的脚泡一下，泡在这个很凉快冰凉的水里面、啊、那个夏天、啊、很多人会喜欢去河边玩，就是因为那个河水比较冰凉、yeah.
Feels so good.
Yeah.
Later, one of his friends decided to go down to the river to wash her hands. So you're out in the wild and you're picking up stuff and maybe got your hands all kind of muddy. So you want to go and rinse them off in the river.
Yeah, 好，那过了一会儿，就所以 Brent 已经先去了。那过了一会儿呢，他的朋友之一决定要去 go down to the river, 就是到河边的意思，因为通常河边会有岸嘛。那河岸到河通常是往下会走一点点。啊、所以这个地方他会用 go down to the river、啊、那中文的话就直接说到河边去，他决定到河边去呢洗洗手。
Okay, now be careful with this because this called up an association in my mind of an English idiom, a specifically American idiom that recalls a very tragic and sad point of our history or aspect of American history. To sell somebody down the river, you can look that up, I won't talk about it nowTo sell somebody down the river, that's 出卖人家 and
yeah.
let them end up in a terrible situation, but it has a really, really awful background to it. Look it up yourself.
嗯，好，大家可以去查一查这个 idiom 它后面的
很悲惨的故事
哈、啊。这个提示一下，跟黑奴有关。
Right.
各位要记得，就这个 idiom 它的意思就是出卖别人的 ，to sell somebody down the river 啊，就出卖的意思。
Yeah, in a very thorough and terrible way.
嗯
，She was surprised that Brent was nowhere in sight, and that's a great expression. Remember that one.
Yeah, to be nowhere in sight 就是看不见啊，没看到他啊，所以他非常的惊讶，说：“哎 ，Brent 怎么不见了？看不到人了？人跑哪里去了呢？”
Right, and the image that my brain calls up first is parents taking their little child or children to some fair or a place where there's lots of people, and the little kid wanders off. Oh, the little girl was nowhere in sight.
啊，就哎，怎么人不见了呢？啊，或者是爸爸妈妈说啊，我去买个冰淇淋给你，在这里不要跑，在这里等我。那买回来一看，哎，怎么人不见了？
嗯，
啊，那就是 to be nowhere in sight.
Don't do that with your kid. Don't leave them standing、
yeah.
alone. Then she saw something that chilled her blood. One of Brent's flip-flops was stuck between two rocks in the river. Now, Wesley jumped in a little too soon,、
yeah.
but there's a reason for it. Mao hao, a colon actually functions a lot like a period sometime. Actually, feng hao, a semicolon is even more like a period. But it is not the end of the sentence. You have to wait for the period.
Yeah, 好，因为那个冒号啊，它其实 句子表示还没有完呢 啊，所以接着呢，他看到了某件事情 chilled her blood 啊，这也是很生动的一个说法，就是让他的血都冰了，血都凉了。那中文当然不会讲说他的血都凉，中文会说让他心都凉了
，or 毛骨悚然 ，or something like that，
yeah, 或者是更强的情况的话，就是让他毛骨悚然，然后就吓了一跳，那个血都冰了啊。那为什么呢？因为他看到哇，怎么 Brand 他的这个夹脚托的一只卡在河里面的两块石头中间啊。那我想大部分人在这种情况之下都会觉得心里面一凉，因为你马上想到的应该是他是不是发生什么意外了、因为没有看到人，只看到拖鞋卡在那边，那我们大脑很快就会去补足很多的画面，就哎呀，他一定掉下去被水冲走了，只有鞋子还留在那里。
Right, especially when we're right by a mountain river.
Yeah, 尤其你在山里面的河流。
Fearing that her friend had been swept away by the strong current, she yelled out Brent's name several times.
这个分词构句啊，她害怕她的朋友呢被冲走了 ，had been swept away， 被什么冲走呢 ？The strong current， current 就是水流啊，所以她担心她的朋友呢已经被这强劲的水流冲走，
急流
啊，那她就 yelled out， 她大喊啊 ，Brent 她的名字喊了几次。啊、那这个当然没有回音、啊、
That's right. And also notice that they notice when people do things right. Don't just notice when they're wrong. Fearing 那个分词构句 The biggest problem is sometimes the next part of the sentence has the wrong pronoun. But in this case, it's very clear and correct.
Yeah, 这个 fearing 这种分词构句大家使用的时候要注意，就是分词构句的主词要跟主要子句的主词是一致，所以这里呢没有错一致，因为担心是谁担心，是 she， 是主要子句那个 she yelled out 那个 she， 所以在这里用的是正确的。
Her loud voice prompted Brent's other friend to join her at the riverbank to find out what was going on.
啊，那他的那个大喊的声音呢 ，prompted 就促使啊 Brent 另外一个朋友啊来加入他啊，在哪里加入他呢？在这个河边啊加入他，那想要干嘛呢 ？Find out what was going on 啊，他想要看一看。到底发生了什么事情啊？那 Riverbank 也是一样，它是重音在前面啊。这个哎，好像是 HBO 还是哪一个节目，它有一个广告很好玩，他就说啊，这个Guess where the fish put their money？ 然后另外一个人就说 Riverbank。
哦、oh, ，It's the name of a bank。
No, but it's a pun.
Oh yeah, got it.
Yeah， 因为两只都是鱼。
Yeah, yeah, that's right. Yeah. I've heard that one before. I forgot it.
yeah, 那重点就是各位。下次碰到这广告的时候，你再听，他念得很清楚，是 Riverbank， 他不是念 Riverbank， 他是 Riverbank。
That's right, because it's a place name, it's just a 就是已经固定的一个字。All right, while she was explaining the situation to her friend, Brent came up to them carrying a long bamboo stick.
好，那当这个女性朋友在解释这个状况给她的朋友听的时候呢 ，Brent 出现了啊 ，came up to them 就走向他们，手上拿着一根长长的竹竿。
What's up?I was just getting this stick to retrieve my flip-flop, Brent explained.
啊，怎么了 ？What's up? 啊 ，What's up? 怎么了？啊，我只是过去拿这一根棍子，要 retrieve. Retrieve 就是取回啊 ，to find something and bring it back. 那我想很
捡回来，
捡回来。所以大家都知道，像这个 retriever 啊，就是猎犬，因为猎犬会去把你打到的猎物都找到，然后带回来给你啊。所以我只不过是拿这个棍子要去把我的夹脚托取回来而已，拿回来而已。
And note that what's up is a really popular greeting now among young people. What's up?
嗯，那 what's up? 现在这个年轻人之间打招呼常常也会这样用，就跟这个 how are you 感觉是一样的。
And sometimes they'll say what's up.
哦，
没有特。
Yeah, 连音啊 ，Yeah.
Okay, his friends burst out laughing, leaving Brent scratching his head.
好，那这个他的朋友呢，就是大笑啊 ，Brent 就在那边抓头，不知道到底发生什么事。
And that is it for today. Make sure you tune in next time. We'll be looking out for you. We'll see you then. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.